viewers, happy Sunday to every one of you. My name is ASUQUO Blessing, and I remain your presenter for the World Changers Forum show here at our favorite house, Rockland House TV, every Sunday by 4 p.m. Today, our topic up for discussion is, why do we have poor people in the country? It's a question that really, really, really bothers me so much. And today, I won't be discussing this alone. I have a man I respect so much, Mr. Michael Udoh, here with me. Please say hi to the house.
Hello, viewers. I remain Udoh Michael.
You're welcome, sir.
Thank you, Mr.
Like we said, our topic for discussion today is, why do we have poor people in the country? You know, every day we tend to walk out to the streets, go to schools, and you see people begging. In fact, now we now have corporate beggars. You see people suffering in the streets and all that. Please, what exactly the issue is? Is it that our country is not doing better, or what exactly is the issue? But before we go into that, I would love to even ask, first of all, do we really have poor people in this country?
Of course, we have poor people in the country.
Okay, so if we do, then let's tend to discuss, why exactly do we have these people? Why do we have these poor people in the country? Please, sir, you have a
call. Thank you very much for having me. Thank you very much. I really appreciate this wonderful opportunity for me to impart in my own home. Thank you, World Changers. So, the reason why we have poor people in the country is, if you check, look at it, ask yourself that question, personalize it first and foremost. Why do we have poor people in the country? You see the reason right from your own self.
Okay.
Now, this is it. Reason why you have poor people in the country is because, as humans, we have not even valued our own self.
Okay.
Not to talk about valuing another person. Permit me to always refer to the Holy Book, because that is, I want to draw strength from the Holy Book.
Okay.
Secondly, I wish and I hope I'll not be biased. So please forgive me if I
no problem,
I came here with a burden in my heart. Came here with a serious burden in my heart, and I really need to make this point clear and straight to everybody. Now, this is how it is. Rockland TV runs today because of humans. It runs today because they have themselves seen to the fact that there is another listening ear at the other end. You see, if you have this mindset, if you have this inculcated in your habits, knowing that whatsoever you do, there's another person watching, there's another person listening. You know that, okay, if I, let's take for example, now let me make it easy so that we can understand it. If I want to run a business today,
okay,
I'm not just going to run the business because of, I have the idea.
Okay.
As important as that is, I'm running a business because I need profits. And I'm also running a business because I know there's another person at the other end to enjoy what I'm doing. You get what I'm saying? So the reason why people are still poor in the country is that they have not really observed and seen the value of themselves first. Not to even talk about the other person.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying? So as it stands now, you must know who you are. Know what you have inside. Like from the Holy Scriptures, from the Holy Book rather, he said, when he ascended up on high, he gave gifts to men. Where is your? So many people have not found themselves, so they remain poor. They die and sink in abject poverty. So until you find your true place, what is that gift that has been deposited inside of you? So until you find that gift, you remain poor.
So can we actually classify that to be low esteem,
not just that. Why that is important, I cannot just come out to the public or come out here and say I have my self-esteem is big, you know, because I have so many backs up or I have so many things I want to do for myself. No, but I must always first, once I define my real self, see the importance of myself. Like I said, Rockland TV runs because there's another listening ears. The earth, the oil in the earth today, it's guarded by what NNPC today because there's a human to enjoy it. So until you find that place that whatsoever you do today, there's another person to enjoy it, you will not be poor. I don't know if I'm making any sense.
Okay, I think the point we're trying to make here is, first things first, is that an individual must actually value him or herself first.
Exactly.
Because if he or she cannot value him or herself, there is no way he or she can be productive.
Exactly.
Okay, so please let's go into mindsets now.
Okay,
because I believe we have so many people with different mindsets. Let's look, is our mindset, or would you explain how our mindset can be the reason why people are poor in the country? Because so many people, they believe, oh, because the economy is not doing well, because something happened, because something happened, because maybe my parents were not rich, that's why I find myself here. What? Can our mindset be one of the reasons? Because to me, I feel our mindset is some of the reasons. Some of them just have this mindset that, oh, you know, I can't be rich because, oh, the country is bad. Please, I would love you to maybe expatiate on it.
Thank you very much. Like I said, permit me again to draw from the holy book.
Okay, you're permitted.
Jesus Christ said to his disciples that, I have so many things to say to you, but as at now, ye cannot bear them now. The things you know now, I am sure you wish you knew them before now.
Okay.
So, what we have actually learned in the past is as a result to where we are today. So your mindset, your mind plays a very important role in your life. Because I think it's the medium of communication.
Okay.
It is how you see yourself that is... That is how you endorse yourself out. So if I say I'm rich, though I don't have physical cash, in my mind, I've pictured it, I've seen it. I have to now carry myself as though what I have seen. If you can imagine it, if you can dream it, then you can achieve it.
Okay.
So if you see, if your mind has not been built up to assimilate to a capacity where it cannot carry positive things, then remain poor for life. Because you have to be rich in your mind first. You have to be very, very rich in your mind. Once you're not rich, it's just like trying to plant a seed on a clay soil. You won't get anything until it is loamy. So until the mind is loamy, there's no productivity.
Let me join you in the draw from that same holy book. I think the same holy book makes us understand. It says, for out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh.
Yeah.
Alright, and also from that same holy book, the Bible makes us understand. It said, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. So, I believe, to my own opinion, I think our mind really matters, like you said. Because if an individual do not think he or she can actually be rich, or he or she can succeed in life, if because of the economy, or because of the way the country is, or because of the way the institution is, that person has that mindset of saying, oh, I would not be able to succeed. Because he or she has that mindset, it's something he or she has programmed, right?
Exactly.
Automatically, it can't be a reality.
Exactly.
That person actually aims to be successful, but because of what he or she has programmed in the mind, that is what will be a barrier towards achieving success, right, sir?
Yes, that is it.
Okay, sir, please. And also look at the aspect of excuses. You know, excuse is something that never lacks in our mouths as youth, you know. We all have an excuse why we can't do this, we can't do that, we can't do that. So please, sir, please, also, I'd like you to shed more light in that also.
Before I go into excuses,
okay.
I really want to establish a fact.
Okay.
This is how it is. Success in life is dependent on relationship.
Okay.
And human, generally speaking. If I choose to be successful, I should have a better relationship with humans.
Okay.
You see?
Yeah.
Manna does not come from above and fall on humans. Maybe we heard it back then, but now, manna does not come from above and fall on humans. So, you must build yourself to a point whereby, you know, you have a good relationship with humans, generally speaking. In our world today, men are the carriers of endorsement. I don't mean men as in man, I mean men as in humans.
Humans, okay. I was beginning to think if women are not part of it. Okay.
Men are the carriers of endorsement. When you see a man coming into your life, you should rejoice.
Okay.
In fact, you start smiling.
Alright, I'm smiling.
So when you see a man coming into your life, you should you don't just smile and smile sheepishly. You smile and discern what this person is coming to do in my life. As for excuses, of course, excuses will never run out from our mouth because we procrastinate a lot. We don't believe things work out. We don't believe it is true. Take for instance the new ride that came to this state, Akwa Ibom State, Open. I've seen some minds outside, honestly speaking, and you know, I charge them a lot. I see some minds outside that it is not real, but they have not tested it. You can't tell me my juice is not sweet when you've not tested it. So people must always make excuses. However, it shouldn't be a barrier to your growth and development. So that is it.
Okay, so viewers, what we're trying to say is that we should learn not to make excuses, because you saying, you know, for instance, for those of us in tertiary institutions, we tend to say, oh, I didn't pass this course because this lecturer asked us to pay something. Oh, I couldn't do this because I didn't have money. I couldn't start that business because there was not enough capital. So that is what unnecessary what excuses. So that shouldn't be an hindrance for you not to what to get rich or for you not to succeed. So what our guest is trying to tell us that do not give excuses. No matter how little it might be, you can start from somewhere. Excuses, give me that little excuse. If a lecturer says pay something, then there is a way you can succeed without something. Do what you have to do, like reading, to make sure you pass that course. Because you giving the excuse of that man wanting to get money, it's not an excuse, because there are people that are passing that course,
exactly,
right, without it. And you saying you need money to do business, and because the money is not enough, money is never enough, right, sir?
Money is never enough.
You just need to start from somewhere. So that little money you have, you can start from it, and I believe from there you will grow.
Exactly.
Okay, sir, please. Also, I would like you make mention of procrastination. You know, I know it's an hindrance to why we are actually poor in this country, why some people, you know, they want to do something and they say, oh, I'll do it tomorrow. In that instance, please, can you please just throw more light on it?
Procrastination, they say, is one major key to kill a man's destiny.
Okay.
Let's take, I would like to use myself as an example. I want to do something today.
Okay.
And I'm like, I can't start it because I don't have capital. Or maybe I have a little capital to start it, but it always seems not enough. So at that point, I won't be able to start. I have procrastinated. Or maybe I want to go somewhere and I'm actually getting there. But along the line, I find myself telling myself that I can't achieve this. I can't achieve this. It's not going to work out. I start devaluing myself. I allow evil thoughts to come into me. I start procrastinating. I start saying things that are not true, that are not real. You get my point? So if you must do something, forget the odds. Even if you see them with your physical eyes, forget the odds. If you can dream it, then you can achieve it.
If you can dream it, then you can achieve. So anything you can dream, please, all you need to do is to take a step. Simply, before we go into how we can overcome being poor and how we can succeed in life, I would like us to look at this this topic, unwillingness to work. You know, most of our youths right now, it's not like they are actually poor. It's not like they don't want to get rich. But, you know, they just want to do this fast method, you know, sleep with men, get money, and then from there they can do what they want to do, engage in different habits. Please, unwillingness to work, is it a barrier? Is it one major reason? Because I think it's one major reason, especially our youth, why they are poor, and that why they will still remain corporate beggars. Because I think they are the ones that are corporate beggars because they dress so slaying, and out there you see them begging for 50 naira, begging for 100 naira, doing things that they cannot afford. So let's talk on unwillingness to work.
This is one thing I love. Okay, our generation today hates what they call waiting.
Okay.
They hate what they call sacrifice. They hate what they call standing or sitting to learn. Back then, back in the days, the school we went to, or let me use our fathers, the school our fathers went to, there was no seats for them to sit. There was nothing like chairs, nothing like table. They stood to learn. Do you understand my point? They stood to learn. Now, some of them might have provision for seats, but however, They gave that sacrifice to stand and learn. In this realm, if you must grow, you must be willing to wait. A tree does not become a tree in a day. The things you chase today are actually there for you. What you just need to do is, I said something, I said, change until you change, you will not bring change.
Okay.
So changing brings change. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes,
so, as it stands now, you must wait. Set out your goals. Set out your visions. Be ambitious. Have a good ambition for yourself. Else, growth will not come. You will not tell me you plant a seed today and expect it to yield fruit tomorrow. So, all this hurry in life is what has brought about slave queens, you know, corporate beggars and all of that. So you must be willing to wait for your own time. Rushing will kill you. We don't serve the Almighty God because He will rush us to bless us. No. There's a process. I believe in the power of process. From nursery, you know, from your plants, from nursery, it grows, you grow before it becomes a tree. That's the power of process. So if you are not willing to wait, then remain poor. That waiting, as you are waiting, you are developing yourself. You are developing your mindset. You are learning through the hard way or the easy way. However, it becomes part of you and it must yield a result because you've paid the price. That is it.
All right. For those of us that are just joining us, this is Rockland House TV. And today our topic up for discussion is, why do we have poor people in the country? We want to smash their hearts. And our guest here is Mr. Michael Udoh, who has made mention of so many barriers, so many reasons why we have poor people. And he made us to understand that one of such reasons is the unwillingness to work by our youths. Most of our youths, we don't want to work. We don't want to put our skills to work. So if we must make it in life, we must be willing to work. He also made mention of procrastination. We must learn not to procrastinate. I'll do it tomorrow. Tomorrow never ends and you never do it. Before we close for today, we'll be looking at how we can actually succeed. Because for every barrier, there's a way you can actually cross those barriers. So what we'll be looking at is, sir, if we found out the reasons why we are poor, how can we overcome this? How can we succeed in life? We'd like you to expatiate more on it.
Okay. First and foremost, there are two things that can make a man succeed in life. One, your skill. Two, your certification.
Okay.
You earn a skill today, you be your own man, you be your own business man, you be your own manager, you be your own CEO, you have people working under you.
Okay.
You earn a certification today, you work for somebody. However, these two things brings success. So how to overcome failure to success or failure in life is, one, you have to develop these two things. Be skillful. Have a good certification. Your skill now would fetch you those things that you are always wanting and crying to have. That's why I made mention of something. I said, until you grow yourself, what you are looking for will not come to you. Just like a child, if you put a bottle of water on the table for a little child who is still crawling, the child has to stand up. And most of the times, when they stand up to get to that water, their hands cannot reach there.
Yeah.
So they need to grow to a point where they will just stretch forth their hands and get it. So you must build yourself, either by certification or your skill. I made mention of gifting. Define yourself. So until there's a good definition about yourself, you remain poor. Now, have a good self-esteem.
Okay.
Grow yourself. Believe in yourself. Be your own self-supporter. You understand what I'm saying?
Don't talk down on yourself. Yeah, some of them, you just look at yourself and they're, me, you know where I'm coming from. Do you think it's actually possible? And because of that, they just
have
all the morale, just, you know,
have self-confidence.
All right.
Believe in your little beginnings.
Okay.
Don't downcast yourself. Don't say, oh, because this person has, you know, I'm doing the same business with somebody, he's yielding increase, I'm not. Believe in your little beginnings. However,
all right, so let's look at persistence, because you know, some of us, it's not like we don't really want to do something, we find ourselves doing something, but we try this particular thing, it's not working out, we try it, and it makes us, you know, you just need to give up and you just need to leave it. So say, please, what do we do in this aspect?
You know, growing up to become what I am today, I grew up with three acronyms.
Okay.
Okay, I call them three P's. Okay. P, P, and P.
Okay.
It's called persistence, perseverance, and patience.
All right.
If you look at it critically, you know that the three work. They work hand in hand. If you're not patient, you can never be persistent. If you're not persistent, you can never be perseverant. You can never persevere. You see? So why you're persisting, note that when you fail, does not mean that you're actually a failure. It means that there are some steps and there are some principles that you've neglected. So you need to check back and see what you've neglected to actually grow yourself and correct yourself. You understand my point? So why persisting? You have to be patient. While you're patient, you have to keep pushing.
Okay. So even when we try something and it's like it's not working out, we should keep on doing that thing. It will get better, right?
Exactly.
To get better, we keep on doing it. Don't give up. That's what you're trying to say.
Exactly.
Okay, sir. How about changing of approach? You know, that sometimes maybe you try, although it's almost working in hand with being persistent, you try a particular thing. I try a particular thing and it's not working out. In that aspect, what do we do? Because me, sometimes I will think, because if you do a particular thing and it's not working out, I just think you should sit and find out what one is actually good at. Because I believe why most of us really fail is because we're not doing something we have passion about. So, sir, please, let's try and interlink that together.
Thank you for the word, passion. Okay. Passion, they say, is a drive to success, to anything you want to achieve. I have the skill to act. You don't expect me to start singing. Because right now, I don't even have the passion for singing. I have the passion to act. So, with that passion, I can get to where I want to go to. So, I cannot just start a business today that I don't have a passion to do. I just ventured into the business because I see you succeeding. I will fail because I don't have the drive. I don't have the passion. So, once you have passion to whatever you want to do, you achieve it.
Okay. So before we close, let's quickly talk on responsibility. You know, most of our youth, we tend to blame others, almost like excuses, you know, taking excuses. That's by responsibility. Most of us, we don't want to assume the fact that we are responsible for ourselves. We feel, okay, somebody own is not my fault, you know. We don't want to take up responsibility. We feel, okay, it's because of the government. And, you know, the government are not putting things in place. There are no jobs. Buhari is not creating jobs. And that's why I'm in this state. What do we do?
A man's success and failure in life is solely dependent on himself.
Okay.
If you're not responsible, if you choose not to take responsibility for your success, remain a failure.
Okay.
If you choose not to take responsibility for your failure, you still die in failure.
Okay.
So it's high time we stand up to be responsible for our actions, for our words, our thought pattern, whatsoever we do. Knowing fully whether the outcome must always be a result, either good or bad.
All right, thank you very much, sir. So please, what would be your advice to our viewers out there?
My advice to my viewers out there is, take these words I give to you today. It comes from my heart. It has worked for me, and I'm sure it will work for you. Have these three words, P, P, P. Persistence, perseverance, and patience. Have a good drive, have a passion, be ambitious. You know, always aim at the top. Do not see yourself failing. Even if you fail, rise up again. What is most important is how much and how many times you stand up and not how many times you fall down.
All right, so no more excuses. Take responsibilities and move towards that goal. And I believe when we keep doing that, we keep pushing, will surely arrive at reaching out to our goal. Thank you very much. I still remain your presenter, ASUQUO Blessing. See you next Sunday, same time, same page. Thank you very much. Bye.